Brothers and sisters, today we celebrate our Thanksgiving Mass for the new year. Our main celebrant is Father Paul, and our concelebrant is Father Joseph. Let's now stand for the opening song.
Thank you. gifts. We praise you, the source of all wisdom on earth. Teach us to acknowledge always the many good things your infinite love has given us. Help us to love you with all our heart, with all our strength. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ yourself, who is yet to reign with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all of this, put on love, that is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you are also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing songs and hymns and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in a word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, the Father through Him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever.
May God have pity on us and bless us. May He let His face shine upon us.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever.
So may your way be known upon earth, among all nations, your salvation.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever.
The earth has yielded its fruits. God, our God, has blessed us.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever.
May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth hear Him.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever.
Please stand.
Concerned for your life, what you are to eat, or for your body, what you are to wear. Life is more important than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They do not sow, they do not reap, they have neither cellar nor barn. Yet God feeds them. How much more important you are than the birds. Which of you, by worrying, can add a moment to his lifespan? If the smallest things are beyond your power, why be anxious before about the rest? Or take the lilies. They do not spin, they do not weave. But I tell you, Solomon in all his splendor was not arrayed like any one of them. If God clothed in such splendor the grass of the field, which grows today and is thrown on the fire tomorrow, how much more will he provide for you, O wicked in faith? It is not for you to be in search of what you are to eat or drink. Stop worrying. The unbelievers of this world are always running after these things. Your Father knows that you need such things. Seek out instead his kingship over you, and the rest will follow in turn. Do not live in fear, little flock. It has pleased your Father to give you the kingdom. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of Jesus, giving thanks to God through him. This is a message from first reading today we just heard. God, through St. Paul, delivered this message to us. Be thankful. And tonight, we offer this Thanksgiving Mass at the very end of the year 2021. We celebrate New Year's Eve Thanksgiving Mass. In this Mass, we give God thanks for all the graces and blessings we have received in the past year. It's a time of gratitude. It's time of Thanksgiving. That's what we are doing now. So everyone, I believe, we all have many things to be thankful for. All the blessings and the graces we have received from God in the past year. So if we look back, we have many things to be thankful for. You know, as a parish, St. Joseph Parish, here in Hong Kong, Cardinal Road, we have many things to give God thanks. Many things. Surely I will, you know, list a few. We have been accomplished many things on the leadership of Father Joseph, and with the blessing of God, and the grace of God. We have accomplished many things. I just list a few for you. The new sound system. So in the back, people now you can hear me, right? Even I have a soft voice, but you can hear me. I remember at the very beginning of this year, we did not have masks because of the pandemic Mass is suspended. We start doing the online streaming Mass. That time, you know, we have a microphone here, but we do not have a microphone system ready for live streaming. So we get another microphone, we put on the speakers over there to get it very close, to get a better sound. But now, it's a much better system we have. So people online now, I'm sure, you can hear us in the chat. This is one of the blessings God gives us in the parish. And also, you look at the very bright, the new painting we did for the inner church hall. We also accomplished this. Now it's more beautiful, more bright. Also, people sitting upstairs in the back. There's a new seating we have. Now at the back, you can see the altar, right? You can see us. See? This is all new thing. All with God's grace and blessings, we can accomplish this. We are grateful to God. And also due to a pandemic, you know, less people coming to church. But now, more and more people coming to church. Look now, you are in the back, standing very proud. This is the grace of God, blessed of God. The Christmas time, if you are here, we have two masses at 9 o'clock and 12 o'clock for Christmas Eve. People are packed in the church, packed in the car park, even off the bridge, filled with people. People coming back to church with God's blessing and the grace. We are thankful to God. We are grateful to you also. Now we have a new toilet is coming up very soon. We hopefully finish end of this month. There will be empty, will be new. And if you come today, pay attention, there's a new house. Yeah, bamboo house. That's one of the things we started to do for celebrating of 150 years anniversary of St. Joseph Church. That's one of the things we do, we live home away from home. All these things, with God's blessing and grace, we have accomplished. Of course, there are many other preparations for 150th anniversary of St. Joseph Church. Many preparations we have been doing. That's one of the things we did. Of course, all these are God's blessing and grace. Tomorrow, the Bishop Stephen Chow will come to start the celebration for 150 years of anniversary of St. Joseph at the 11:30 Mass. So all this God's grace and blessing. Surely, then my list goes on for many, but I just suggest a few. You know, without God, we cannot do anything. We can do nothing. But with God's grace and all the efforts of many volunteers and the participation of all of you, we accomplished so much so far. We are grateful to God. We are thankful to God. Gratitude is not merely for tonight. Not the end of the year we give God thanks. Gratitude made to be a way of life. Every day, every moment of our life, we can be grateful. We should be grateful. Gratitude is a way of life. But to be grateful for a moment, for only tonight, once a year, at the very end of the year, is easy. But it becomes a way of life, have some difficulties. We all know, life have ups and downs. Life doesn't go always as we wish. Sometimes we feel happy. Sometimes we feel unhappy. Sometimes we feel joyful. Sometimes we feel very dull. This is the life. But for us, you know, we should be always grateful. But that's not easy. We spend the time when we feel down. It's not easy to give God thanks. When we are all happy, everything goes as we wish. We always say, thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. It's good. But when things go against our will or our wish, then we ask God, why me? How come, God, this happened to me? It's not easy to give God thanks. It's not easy to be always grateful. Take distance for the pandemic again. Affect each one of us. All of us. Also now, it seems endless. You know, once we feel this calm to almost, you know, we are almost under control. But the new variant came. It seems endless. How can we be thankful for this in this kind of a situation? Surely, you know, the direct or indirect, the consequences of this, you know, will always make us unhappy. But if we reflect on our life, you know, we are here. You are here. I'm here. You know, we are here. That means the persistence in faith, we can be thankful for God. Thankful to God. Also, more opportunities online nowadays, because in many online masses and talks, we can be thankful for this. Of course, this, you know, situation makes us more humble. Make us more the feel of the need of God. This humbles us. We realize we cannot do by ourselves. Our life cannot be without God. And this, you know, make us humble to realize, you know, we need God in our life. We cannot do it alone. We need God in our life. So, all this, you know, we, only thing we need in this kind of condition, this kind of situation, we need to ask God. Because God, we just celebrate Christmas. God is Emmanuel. God is with us. God never leave us alone. God is always with us. So when we feel grateful, everything we can consider or see is a gift. Is a gift from God. We take many things for granted in life without notice. You know, the air we breathe, although it's more difficult with a mask, but we do breathe the air for our life. It's a very basic necessity in our life. We take for granted that this is a gift from God. Everything, if we are grateful, everything is a gift. If we are grateful, we can always content. Content with what we have. Content with what God gives us. There's no competition with each other. That's only creativity. There's no competition, no jealousy. Lord, we humble each other. All we humble. If we are grateful, we are content with what we have. We are satisfied with what God gave us. Because, you know, God loves us always. You know, in the gospel reading, it says, God's love for the care, the everlasting. Even God cares for the bird in the air, and also lily on the field. But for us, it says very clearly, much more important the bird and the lily. So God takes care of us. Because God is always with us. God always cares for us. God always standing with us. So we are very grateful tonight because we have such a God. We have such a God who loves with us, who cries with us. We have such a God who rejoices with us, but struggles with us. We have such a God shares with our joys and sorrows. We are very grateful we have this God in our life. We are very grateful we have this faithful God always in our life. No matter we are happy or sad, God always standing by us. He with us, strengthen us, and comfort us. This is the God we have. We are grateful. So whatever made us all happy in the passing year, so we leave all this behind, because in a few minutes we will be a new year. So we ask God for healing, ask God for blessing, because we have faith in God. We trust such a God. So we hope, not only hope, we firmly believe that next year, with God's grace and blessing, the year 2022, will be a year filled with hope, God's blessing, good health, prosperity, joy, and peace. So may God bless all of you, and Happy New Year. Now we open our packages. As we come to this last day of 2021, we want to give thanks to God for sustaining the world through a most difficult year and for all the blessings received.
We pray for Pope Francis, all the bishops, priests, and deacons. May they be instruments of peace and unity in communities where hatred and division reign. We pray, Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For all who gave generous support in many ways to people sick and in crisis during the coronavirus pandemic, which in many ways has revealed the best characteristic of our human nature, we pray,
Lord, hear us.
For our planet Earth and the universe, created through the Son of God, that we may create this common home, that we may care for this common home with responsibility, we pray.
Lord, hear us.
For times past, that we may give thanks for God's blessings, repent of our foolishness, pray for those we have offended, and entrust to God those for whom it was a dreadful year. We pray.
Lord, hear us.
For the new year, that as we must shape a new society, we may move into it with confidence, for it is another year of the Lord. We pray.
Lord, hear us.
Let us rain our hearts with the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, hear us.
Almighty God, may we follow you more nearly, love you more dearly, day by day, year by year, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Father,
on the ever living God. We look well always and everywhere to give you thanks. Through your beloved Son, you created our human family. Through him, you restored us to your kindness. Therefore, it is your right to receive the obedience of all creation, the praise of the church on earth, the thanksgiving of your saints in heaven. We too rejoice with the angels as we proclaim your glory forever.
May we be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to fullness of eternity, together with our Pope Francis, our Bishop Stephen Joe, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, this Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and this Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, We may mend the because ears to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Lord, I'm not willing that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. God, our Father, in this spiritual food you have given back to us, the sacrifice we offer you in thanksgiving, the saintly sacrament of Christ yourself. By this gift of strength and joy, sustain us in your service, the blissful gift of eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So please sit. So before we do the final blessing, I would have to say there is a blessing of this St. Joseph paintings. We called Go to St. Joseph. That will be 1 year's, half year, 6 months celebration. We're going to pray many things. So now we're going to bless it. But before bless it, I would like to invite Peter to tell us what is this Go to St. Joseph? What is this painting about? So thank you.
Pope Francis issued an apostolic letter within a father's heart and a very devout Catholic artist by the name of Miss Jackie Lau Yun Ting, who was deeply moved. Suddenly, there seemed to be a voice deep in her heart that said to her, "Take up your painting brush and draw me." 38 painting of the portrait of St. Joseph were drawn up within a period of 6 months. We understand that before painting, Jackie prayed to the Holy Spirit to help her and guide her. With God's merciful love, she has an endless source of creative inspiration which moved her to become the paintbrush of God. These paintings were among some paintings of hers exhibited in St. Joseph Church, Kowloon Bay. Now, we not only have 38 paintings of St. Joseph, we have 12 more. Together we have 50, because she has kindly painted another 12 for us for the exhibition. We named this Go to Joseph. The meaning of Go to Joseph, you can see the meaning in Father's message in the board over there later. Father Joseph went to see the exhibition. He was very impressed with them, moved by all these marvelous paintings. He decided to move them over here to coincide with our 150 years celebration, which all now we see them. The Father Joseph used the theme. In Latin, it is called Ite et Joseph, which is Go to Joseph. You can read the origin, as I said, and the meaning in the message there. Father Joseph emphasizes that you don't look at the picture, painting, from an artistic point of view. Oh, good one, colorful. No. With an open heart, let them impress you, inspire you, give you special feelings. Put down your reflection in writing and jot in the box or make it through the design Go to Joseph QR code. It will be used for spiritual sharing purpose. God bless. And Father,
now we're going to bless these 50 paintings about St. Joseph. So after that, we're going to bless everyone for ending our today's Mass. Then after that, we still have 5 minutes for calm down. So I think if you come on the DVD for the calm down, then after 5 minutes, we can use that. But now, so let us put our heart in the chest, and then let us ask God to bless this painting first. So please stand, let's pray. The Lord be with you. O God, source of all grace and holiness, look kindly on your community of St. Joseph Parish. May they imitate the virtues of St. Joseph. Well, we celebrate the 150th anniversary of the parish. May we remember those who have been cultivating the community. May we joyfully continue your mission of building this community as a home for all those who are away from home. May we renew in our heart your love and be an instrument of peace through the intercession of St. Joseph, and also through all these images we have. The guardian of your beloved Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all these paintings, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So let us be still. We're going to pour the holy water on this painting. Because it's so crowded, so we will not walk, maybe only two sides. Then after that, we go to bless everyone. Before the new year comes,
There are, okay, I think the people are very noisy. Let's do one game, what I used to do. While I was in the Wuhan, I used to do this. Wait. Okay. Let's do one thing. If I say, God is love, what do you answer? All the time. When I say, all the time. God is love.
All the time.
Very good. Let's go again. God is love. In 5 minutes, we do calm down. But before this New Year comes, a few words to say to our parishioners. Contribute their energy, time, and then to make our parish a home. So, if there is some part which is as the priest, behalf of the parish, behalf of Father Paul and me, it reminds you. Do you, in your mind now, do you have anyone in your mind which is you love the most? Who is